Well, we're ready to go play some more baseball. Obviously, the SEC tournament was a great experience for us, but now we're ready for the postseason where you get a chance to go play for Omaha. So we'll be excited. We were going to be excited no matter where we're going, so now we're focused on Ohio State.
Have you heard any rumblings about where it might be, like a Conway or Chapel Hill and Earl Green?
I mean, I heard the same things that everybody heard. You know, it probably would be local, probably not a flight. So past that, you know, it was just waiting to see.
What do you know about the teams in this race?
Well, East Carolina was in the conference that I came from last year, the American Athletic Conference. So we're used to playing that for the last 3 years. Ohio State, I know very little about. So, you know, our staff will get to work immediately.
How big of a sense of relief was it seeing your name pop up there, and how awesome was that in just your first year?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think we knew we were in. Right. I think everybody that follows college baseball closely knows that we did enough. When you win 18 games in this league, you're going to be in the NCAA tournament. There's no question about it. But when you see your name up on that screen, a lot of things go through your head. You remember the first team meeting. You remember the ups and the downs, because we've obviously had a lot of those this year. So it's a culmination of that team, those student-athletes, and they're getting rewarded for all the hard work. That makes you feel good as a coach.
Mark, how proud are you of this team for being 20-17 at one point and then storming back to get here?
Very proud. I mean, the worst thing you can say about a team is they may not fight when they get down. You can't say that about this team, and you won't say that about this program. We were at a fork in the road at 20-17, and this program responded the way our fans, the way our administration, the way Ray Tanner wants this team to respond. We got really good, real quickly. So I'm real proud of it.
What do you recall about your trip to East Carolina, the facilities, the crowds, and all the college?
Yeah, it's a good program, good coach, really good fan support. It'll be a tremendous challenge.
Coach, it's going to be about 8 days off that you guys have until you play on Friday. What's that time been like so far, and how do you approach it now as you guys get ready and know where you're going?
Well, probably there's no team in America that needed a little bit of time off than us because of our injuries, because of playing two games in a row until 2:30 in the morning and then having to play a game the next day. So I think it'll be very good for us. Last couple of days we're just about recharging the batteries for the entire team. We'll get back to work today. The weather's not going to allow us to get on our field, so we'll sneak over to the football complex and get some work on in there. Just take it one day at a time, getting ready for Friday.
Mark, how are the injuries specifically, TJ?
Yeah, TJ's still day-to-day. We're going to be cautiously optimistic that he could help us this weekend in a bigger capacity than he has. But we also need to be smart about it. That hamstring, the back, you know, whatever the case may be with these guys, all of them, we have to be smart. But when the guys want to play, you know, sometimes it's tough to keep on.
Have you thought about starting pitching rotation yet?
Yeah, we have some ideas about how we might want to attack it. We're not ready to announce that yet. We just want to make sure all our ducks are in a row there. But we have some ideas for what we might want to do.
Did Coach Tanner give you any message before this all began today? What's the last thing he talked to you about before you guys see him up there on the screen on the national broadcast?
Yeah, it was. He just wants us to enjoy this. I think he's really proud of his team and what they accomplished this year. But he also wants us to stay hungry. You know, we approach things very similar, him and myself. We're very happy and appreciative of where we are. But we're also very greedy. We want to keep going. So you know, I think in that regard, we're very much on the same page.
Coach, with all the craziness that you guys went through at the SEC tournament, how do you think that prepared maybe more your young players for what they're going to expect on this tournament time?
Yeah, there's no question. This league and that tournament prepares you to play pretty much anywhere. You go on the road to Texas A&M, that's pretty tough. When you go on the road to Vanderbilt, that's pretty tough. When you play LSU in Florida, that's pretty tough. So this team is used to playing tough games, tough series, so that won't be an excuse. If we don't play well, that won't be an excuse. We're prepared to play good baseball. Now it's just a matter of pulling out the
win. Did anything jump out at you about the field, the surprise, whether it was the integration of your team, the confidence, or anything else?
No, I mean, I think obviously the SEC is very highly regarded. In fact, a ton of teams in. I think the committee had some really tough decisions there on the last four in, the last four out. But you know, Ray Tanner obviously knows how baseball runs in the country. So at the end of the day, I think we're probably good. Really good job, and probably just about the way to do it.
You mentioned using the football facility as the indoor.
Yes. Yeah, we'll go over there. We can't get on our field, so we'll go over there, throw, take some ground balls, and run some sprints.
How much emphasis do you guys, or how much work will you get if the weather stays bad? Or you'll be able to get
we'll be able to hit plenty. You know, the good thing about indoor batting cages is you can get just as many swings indoors as you can outdoors. Obviously, you prefer to hit outside, but we'll get our work at least today offensively in the batting cages.
Yeah.